Welcome back to the Python tutorial. So in this tutorial we are going to learn about Python packages. So in earlier videos we have learned about the modules, the Python modules, like modules like contains the Python statements and definitions like functions and class definitions and etc. So we will learn in this chapter, we will be learning the Python modules, like what is modules means. The module contains multiple modules, like in this chapter we are going to learn packages. So what do you mean by packages? Now I'm going to explain you what is the package and how to use packages and how to import the packages, how to create the packages in Python. So now multiple modules are together to form a package, like in example. So if there are n number of modules are there, so we are combining those modules into us to make a form, combine into together single model, that is called a packages. Example, if several files are there in the directory, so those files are combined and put together into a single package, that is called the packages. So package basically directory or a Python file. So with the name init.py, that is a Python package. If anything inside that init.py comes under, that will be considering as a Python package. So which means that a directory inside with Python path, so which contains the name init.py, whichever files or directory contains with the inside the init.py file, that consider that one treated as a Python package. So it's possible to put several modules into packages. So we can combine several modules and put in inside the packages. So packages are the like a way of structuring the Python modules namespaces, like by using the dotted module names. So now I explain like that by using init, whatever the modules comes under the init.py file, so those are the considered the Python packages. So now I will give one sample example, like simple is the package name. So inside that I have the a.py and b.py and init.py. So this is the my structure, my Python file structure. So here simple is the Python package name, and a.py and b.py are the two modules, that is Python files or Python modules or Python classes, so we can consider. And init.py, inside that one we have the init.py, that is the Python package. So how many this can be contain any number of Python modules. So now I will explain you how to organize the Python project into packages. Like, so if I have a project, so I want to organize it in the form of packages. So for that we have to first create the directory, then navigate to the created directory and create the Python package in that one. So and then navigate to the created Python package and create a Python file. So now I will go here and show one example how to do these all things. Simple, go to the Python, then first create package. So I will show here. So this is my Python ID. I will comment this code. So first create a directory here, right click on the project and create new, select directory. So name the directory, I will give name as my directory. My dir is the directory. First step, we have to right click on the project, then select the new, then select a directory. Now we will show how to create and how to navigate to the create a directory and create a Python package. So you can right click on the create a directory and create the Python package. See, right click on the directory which you are given name. So in my case, I have given the my dir as the directory name. Right click and select the new and select the here you can see Python package. Select the Python package. So I will give Python package name like my PyPack. I will give PyPack. So this is my package. See, when you created, see automatically this init.py file will be created. So this shows that this is the Python package. So whatever you are creating file inside this only created. Now I will create on the file. So right click on the package and select new and select the Python file. So when you select Python file, I will give one demo. I'll write Python file name as pack one. Okay, this is my Python file. Okay, I will select Python file. See, now whatever files I have created, that will be coming under the init.py. This shows this is the my pack is the package. So inside this we have the init.py. This is the main package. So all the files which are we are creating, that will comes under package, inside the package only. Now I will create one more file, pack two. See, whatever how many files you are going to create, that is those all are comes under init.py only. Okay, this is how to create and now we have understood how to create a directory and how to navigate to the that created directory and create the and in that directory we have to create the Python package, and in that package we have to create the Python files. So now I will going to demonstrate one example so that you will get to how to use these details, so you will get to understand it. See, now I have created pack one. Inside that I have created a pack one and pack two as my Python file. Now inside this directory I will create one more package. So we have to right click on the my directory, click on new, select Python package. So my pack two is the my package name. See here, you can see that this is the my package. See, this is the pack one, is this is the pack one, and this is I'll rename so that you can easily understand this one. To rename this, click on the refactor and click on the rename. So my pack one, okay, refactor, okay, fine. See, this is the my pack one and my pack two. Sorry, okay, PyPack. Okay, I'll leave this one also rename. Factor, rename. PyPack one and PyPack two are the my two packages, Python packages. Inside that, in PyPack two, I have created the inside my pack one, I have created the two files. So here I will create one two files here also, so that we can demonstrate the example easily. So here pack two, okay, pack1.1. So this is pack1.1 and here pack2.2. See, you can see the structure of this file. This is main directory and this is the sub directory, means this is the Python package. Inside this I am using these files. So this pack one and pack two are the Python file. So this is the main package two, like that, that is the Python package two. Inside that, so I am using created two files, again 1.1 and 1.2. these are the two files. So now I am going to demonstrate one example. Okay, now for this I will use, see now here, so I have created the two packages, that is package 1 and package 2. These are the two packages, package 1 and package 2. So inside that I have created the Python file. This is py1 and py2. These two are the different file with in different directory. Now I am working with the Python py1. This is in this is in a Python package 1. So I have to this is the statement I have written in the Python python in second directory file. So I am accessing this file in the Python directory 1, that is package 1. Now you have to use the from my pack, so pack 2. See, this is the, I am accessing this file in the package 1. So now I am working with the package 1 and accessing package 2 files. From pack 2 import, what I want to import, I want to import the py2 file. So now I will print something here. Hello, I am py1 file from package 1 or pack 1. So I'll run the program. I have to get output this along with this py2, because this is I am importing here. So I will get the both the output here. See, we can notice. Hello, this is py2.py file from pack 2. Here is the, this is the pack 2. Hello, this is a py2.py and file from pack 2. And this is the this statement. So this is the simple usage of packages in Python. So I hope you have understood this, how to use the packages and how to create packages and how to combine, how to access by using from statement and how to import. So I hope you have understood. So I'll stop video here. Thank you. Welcome back to the Python tutorial. So in this video tutorial, I'm going to explain the Python pip. So here we are understanding what is pip and how to install it, and like how to uninstall and what are the uses of the pip. So now I will show how to work with the pip statement. So basically pip means it's a Python package. So Python package manager means it includes all the packages for the installation purpose. Like for example, so whatever the packages we are installing in Python, so we use the keyword called a pip. So example, pip install and package name. So it includes the bundle of packages within that one. So pip acts like as a package manager. So it can like import the all the statements. Like if we have the Python version 3.4 version later, so the by default Python will be included pip versions. If you are using 2.0 version or below the 3.4 version, so manually you have to install the pip manager. So now, like what is, like now we have to understand something bit about the packages. So package contains like all the files you need for the modules to work with modules. So we have to need a bundle of packages. So that package will be installed through pip command. So now I will show you how to check whether the pip is installed in your system or not. So now I am checking in my PyCharm ID, or you can check in the command prompt also. So now I have installed in PyCharm and I am working with the PyCharm. So here I will check the whether pip installed or not. So to check that one, you should go for, here is the terminal option. So click on the terminal, so it will open the prompt. So and here type the pip --- versions. So this is the command to check whether the pip is installed or not. See, I can show here pip is installed. So which means if your Python version is like greater than 3.4, so automatically pip is installed by the system itself. Next, I will explain like one example, like how to download the packages by using the pip. So for example, I will download on the camel case is the package name. So I will download the package name with using the camel case. So I will show the example here. See, if your Python version is 3.4, it will automatically install the pip. Otherwise, you have to install. See the command to install. Now, first I will check the my Python version. So I will show how to check the Python version. So type Python --- version to check the installed Python version. See, this is my latest version. So I need not be install the pip. It will automatically install by the Python itself. So if you are using Python below the 3.4 version, so you have to need to install the manually. So now I will tell how to install. This is the to install the command like pip install, and you can specify the like packages name if you want. So yeah, to install like any package, I have to give the command, means module name here. So now I will install pip install. So now I'll working. So I, as I explained earlier, so I will be installing the camel case package. That is the package name. So camel case is the package name. So I'm installing this package. See, pip install and package name. So whatever your package you want to see, this shows the collecting the downloading the packages. So installing the collector package. See here, installed the successfully. Now we can work with camel case package. So installed package. Now I will show one example how to import that statements and all. So here I have to import the statement, the means package. So import camel case. C small, okay, camel. So you can import here camel case, and there is a model called camel case, so we are referring that. So C is my reference variable, and I am using the camel case, camel case dot camel case, and I'll take one text here. So I'm declaring one text here. So C is equal to, this is my text. So I will hello, I am using camel case module, and I install, and I have installed this package through pip manager. Pip is a pip package manager. Okay, now I will print the text. Sorry, I'm not I'm printing here. So now what I'll get is the answer, same answer I will be getting. See, there is no changes because I have not used the functions. So just I imported the method and I have not used any functions. There is a function called hum. So by using that one, I can capitalize the or capitalize the each words in the each letters or words in the string. So See, now just I'm printing the text, so I'm not using any inbuilt functions here. So as same as it is, I'm printing the text. Now in second line, I'll use the sum of the functions which is present in the camel case model. So t dot, so capital is the one method, and print t dot. So I will use upper. So this will be printing all the uppercase letters. You can see that I'm running a program. See. So this is the first statement without using any models present in the camel case. Next, I am using the capitalization. Capitalize is a method which capitalize the first letter or a first character letter. So here, see, you can see H is capitalized. Next, I am using the uppercase method. So uppercase, it will print all in uppercase letters. So now I will use different. Print t dot so now print t dot see I have stored here in c variable, right? Okay, I will use that variable c dot hump is the one, so I will pass the text here. So by using this one, so I can get each is a capital words. Okay, hump, sorry, I have to store this string, right? So I'm storing in which variable I'm storing? Just a minute, I'm storing in. Okay, I'm storing this in, so I am storing this in C, and text is see why I got error is, so I am missing here, just a minute. Okay, also I have to take the camel variable, this is the I'm storing in camel case variable, I'm storing in C dot I want each letter should be capital, each first letters of each in this given string. So I want first letter should be capital, so H should be capital and I should be capital. So for that we are using the hump function. So here I have to pass the text. So here I missed the opening and closing parenthesis. It is a function. So now I will run the program. See, now I am getting the first letter should be initialed in capital letters. So next I'll use some of the inbuilt functions. Dot hump is a stop words is there, so you can use, I think we will try this one with this, whether it will work or not. Okay, not work because it's not calling. Okay, so this is the usage in pip. By using pip we can work with this. Now we got to know how to install with the pip by using the pip command and some of the packages. So in this example I have demonstrated and installed a camel case package. Now I want to remove the package, so how to do that one? So we have the command uninstall is the package, uninstall is the command to uninstall the packages. Now I am going to uninstall the camel case package. So here open the terminal here and type pip uninstall, type the pip uninstall camel case. So this is the command to uninstall the packages by using pip manager. So now I'm going to run this, so it will be removed. See, would you remove? Yes, proceed. Yes, so now we can notice it successfully uninstalled the camel case 0.2. This is the versions. So this is the how to install and how to install and how to uninstall package we understand. So by pressing Y, it will remove. If I press no, it will not remove the package. Now, list the packages. So we have a command called list. So to use the list command, it will list the all the packages installed on our system. So I want to know the which all packages I have installed in my system. So for that I have the command called pip list. So this will show what all the packages I have installed in my system. So you can see that I have these many packages I have installed in my system by using the pip manager. So this is the command to check whether which are the packages I have installed by using the pip manager. So I hope that I will stop this video. So I hope you have understood. Thank you for watching video.